Hi there, I'm Peng Shenhao, a graduate student at the Chinese University of Hong Kong. I'm very happy to share our recent work using multi-agent reinforcement learning to simulate self-driven particle system, especially the traffic flows. This work is supervised by Professor Bolle Zhou. In the very beginning, let's briefly review what is self-driven particle system. SDP can model a wide range of multi-agent system in nature and human society, such as the bird flocks, fish school, human crowd, and traffic systems. In the SDP system, each individual pursues its own goals and interacts with each other. During such interaction, very complex social behavior can emerge. So that's why we are so interested in simulating SDP system. We focus on simulating a typical type of SDP system, the traffic system. In this video, we show the footage on the roundabout environment. If we can use virtual agents to simulate the human driver behavior, we can easily to figure out the reasons and motivation of those complex behavior. This will benefit the downstream applications, such as developing an intelligent transportation system and also developing self-driving cars. There is this many ways to simulate such traffic flows. Multi-agent reinforcement learning is a promising approach. However, previous work might not be suitable to this new setting. For example, in a cooperative setting, all the agents need to cooperate to maximize a joint reward, which is not going to lead to the realistic behaviors. For example, the agent might learn free riding and also learn to sacrificing themselves to maximize the joint reward. In the competitive settings, agents will form the adversarial relationship, and this is not also expected in the real-world traffic scenario. The mixed motive RL is a similar setting to us, where the agent pursue their each own goals. But in this work, we focus on simulating the human driver behaviors instead of trying to finding an optimal solutions to the games of mixed motive RL. Besides, we also test our method in a very complex driving scenario instead of the relatively simple real-world environment. There is some relevant works focused on simulating traffic system. For example, in the flow simulator, the researcher trying to learn the high-level controller to the traffic flows. However, in this simulator, the detailed behavior might not exhibit. In the smart simulator, MRL methods are used to train the agents in different traffic conditions. We propose a novel MRL method to train the traffic flow in a more challenging environment with a large scale of RL agents and a complex road network. We summarize the key feature of SDP system here. The first, each individual is self-interested. And because of this feature, the relationship between the agent is time-varying. For example, the agent can form cooperation relationship. Like in this environment, the agent learn to yield to others. But the agent can also be competitive, such as in this environment, the agent learn to cut in others so they can drive faster. So to face these new kind of features, there is some challenge to the current methods. First is that how can we adopt existing method to this new setting? And the second is that how can we learn a socially compliant behavior in the population using current methods? To tackle this challenge in this work, we propose coordinated policy optimization, a novel MRL method, in short of COPO. COPO can facilitate bi-level optimization to optimize the population to achieve the social behavior and very efficient populations. COPO agents can learn realistic crowd actions. In this roundabout environment, we can find that a large scale of RL agents exhibit very coordinated behaviors. And also, COPO can learn safe driving, such as in this bottleneck environment, the agent learn to yield to others. And also, COPO can learn social behaviors, such as in this very challenging, unprotected intersection environment, agent learn negotiation and observing others' behavior so that it can go through this intersection safely. Now we'll briefly discuss the methodology of COPO. First of all, let's consider an agent that we're going to optimize. We call this target agent. We can easily to draw a neighborhood of this agent, And we collect the individual reward from the environment of the current agent. We can also compute a neighborhood reward, which is the average reward of all neighbors of a given agent. The first level optimization is called a local coordination. In local coordination, we try to maximize both of these two rewards. And the second level optimization is called a global coordination, where we're trying to maximize the global reward, which is the summation of reward of all agents. This is called a global coordination. Now we first discuss the local coordination. We propose an idea called a local coordination factor, LCF, here. It is an angle range from negative 90 degree to the positive 90 degree. We use LCF to weight sum two rewards and form the coordinated reward here. The coordinated reward is used to compute a coordinated objective, JC, here, following the PPO loss, for example. And we use this objective to update each policy independently. This is local coordination, which remains a very major challenge, is that how can we determine LCF phi here? Suppose we manually assign the LCF phi equal to 0 degree, then the coordinated reward will reduce to the individual reward, and the current local coordination will reduce to independent learning. This learning will lead to aggressive agent, as shown in this video, because agent only learn to maximize their own reward without aware of others. On the contrary, if we manually assign the phi to 90 degree, then the coordinated reward will reduce to the neighborhood reward, and we are going to learn conservative agent here, because agent only learn to yield to others so that it can let its neighbors to earn reward for it. How can we determine the LCF more intelligently? We use global coordination to achieve this. In the global coordination, we first get a concept called a global objective. The global objective is defined as the reward of all active agents at all time step. And we are going to optimize the LCF phi to maximize the global objective. How can we achieve this? We use the idea of meta gradient. Here we write down the global objective, and we can easily compute the meta gradient of the global objective with respect to the LCF phi. And this meta gradient can be easily decomposed into two parts. The first part is the gradient of the global objective with respect to the updated policy parameter theta nu. And this is obviously the policy gradient. We can easily to write down the equations here. And the second term, we can use the Taylor expansions on the parameters of the policy and build a connection between the LCF with the coordinated objective, JC here. And after these two terms, we can write down a complete loss corresponding to this meta gradient. In the loss, we use the red box here to mark the relationship between the global objective and the LCF. This loss here is much more simplified. Please refer to the paper for a detailed deduction. Now we make a brief summary of the COPO method. First of all, we have a target agent, and we can collect the individual reward from the environment of the target agent. And then we can compute the neighborhood of this agent and compute the neighborhood reward by averaging all the rewards in the neighborhood. And this two reward is missed by the LCF, using an equation of coordinated reward leading to the coordinated objective, which is used to update each individual policies. This is called a local coordination. And then we compute a global reward by summing up all the rewards of the active agent in the environments. And we use this to compute a meta gradient with respect to the LCF. This is called a global coordination. We then update the LCF according to this objective. So this is the whole process of COPO method. To evaluate and test different methods, we propose 5 multi-agent traffic simulation environments. They are the roundabout, tailgate, bottleneck, intersection, and the parking lot environments. These 5 environments are powered by the MetaDrive, a lightweight and efficient driving simulator. We first compare the success rate of different methods. The success rate here is defined as the ratio of agents achieving their destinations. We compare the baseline independent PPO and the centralized creative method mean failed PPO, also the curriculum learning method, with the COPO. We can find that COPO outperforms all baselines in all environments with a large margin in the success rate. Besides, we also compute the efficiency and safety as two extra metrics to evaluate the trend populations. The efficiency here is defined as the total number of success in a given time interval, and the safety is the total number of crashes happening in the environment. The lower, the better. We can find that the proposed COPO method can learn population that achieve best result in the intersection environment. In this video, in these slides, we're going to show four videos in a top-down view of the trend populations of different methods. We can find that the COPO agents can learn much more coordinated behavior compared to independent PPO. We use the red dots to indicate the crashes happening in the environment. The red dots in the independent PPO are much more than the COPO population. In this slide, we show the detailed behavior of COPO agents. In the intersection environment, COPO can learn queuing, yielding, rushing, negotiation, and so on, and other detailed behaviors. In the roundabout environment, the COPO agent can also learn cutting and bypassing. That's all for this sharing. For more information, we welcome you to visit our webpage and read the paper of this work. I'm Peng Zhenghao. Hope you enjoy this work. Thanks.